of Michigan, USA. He is also certified in Introduction to Data Science in Python, University of Michigan, USA. He is also certified in Applied Text Mining in Python, University of Michigan, USA, and TensorFlow Developer Deep Learning Certification in AI, USA. And his master's degree is from Master of Administration with Human Resource Management and Marketing Management from JNTU, Hyderabad. His bachelor's degree in Mathematics, Statistics, and Computer Science from Kakatiya University, Warangal. We are glad to have you here, sir. Hearty welcome from Aurora's PG College, Ramantapur, for the FDP. We welcome you, sir. Now I hand over the station to you, sir.
Thank you, Pradhuma, madam, introducing me to the audience. It's a great privilege to me to be part of this program. Hello, everyone.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Yeah.
We can see you and hear you clearly.
Yeah, good morning to everyone. My name is Badrara. Already, madam introduced myself. I am presently working as an associate technical architect at Quantify Analytics Private Limited. I'm handling different types of projects in my company. I'm an ex-employee of Aurora Group of Institutions. That's I want to remember to everybody. Let's we start. Yeah, before starting my session, I want to ask one thing to everyone. After completing my session, I will ask some 5 questions quiz. Whatever topic I'm going to discuss, based on the topic, you need to answer in the chat bot. So you will receive surprise gift for that answers.
Yes, sir. You can, sir. You can.
Madam, I'm getting disturbance. My screen is visible to everyone. My screen is visible. Hello.
Yes, sir, we can see your presentation.
Yeah, thank you. Just give me 1 minute. Yeah, today I'm going to discuss about statistical applications for analytics and data science. Today's agenda is what is data science, types of machine learning, key statistical algorithms of data science, data science workflow, applications of machine learning, applications of deep learning, applications of natural language processing. So before going to that, I want to ask some questions to you. Suppose we have the data like this, 2, 4, 8, 10, 12. So what is the next value? Anybody? Hello.
Yes, sir.
I'm audible to you.
Yes, sir, you are clearly audible and we can see your presentation also.
Okay. My question is, we have the data like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. What is the next value?
Please change the slide.
Sorry?
So please change the slide so that we can see the slide. Next slide. This is the first slide agenda you are seeing in the slide. So can
Yeah,
you use the
I am generally asking the question for that.
It is 12, sir. 12.
Yeah, exactly. How we will know that 12?
It is a sequence, it is following a sequence of two adding. Two,
Yeah,
four, six, eight
exactly.
is +2, +2. Yes, sir.
Yeah, we have the data like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. The next digit is 12. How we have analyzed that depends on our past data. So the data is very important to do any prediction. That is the thing I want to share you. And whenever we have the data, our prediction will give the better accuracy to us. And here I am using different types of the terminologies that may confusing to you. I don't want to go for the complex terminologies. I will go and give you some generalized terminologies to everyone. And why data science is required? What is the difference between analytics and analyst and data science? Analytics and analysts are working for only doing the statistical operations, and they are using maximum statistical techniques, basic statistical techniques. The data science people are using advanced statistical techniques. That is only the difference between data analytics and data science. When we are talking about the data analysts, they are maximum belongs to data visualization side. They are visualizing the data and finding some patterns in the data. That is belongs to data analyst. So I hope everybody understand what is the difference between data analyst, data analytics, and data science. Nowadays, trending topic is the data science. Data science is a part of the artificial intelligence. So maximum in the analytics side, we are doing the predictive analytics, and data science covering all these data analytics part and data analyst part and everything. This is data analytics, and data analyst is a part of the data science, and data science is a part of the artificial intelligence. Keep these are all the words. I will ask 5 questions end of my lecture. You have to answer whatever questions will come. You have to focus on those questions. So in this actual traditional programming, we are using like this. When we are using the traditional programming, in that traditional programming, what will be there? We have the some data. We need to find the solution for data. We have like input 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I want to get the output like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So for this, what we have to do? We have to get the steps here. Here we have the processing steps. X equals to something. We will take the X value. Some computer people are there. They may understand this. We will take the X is a list values, and we are multiplying with the 2. We will get the Y value. This is traditional programming. Whatever programs are doing their work in the organizations. But coming to the data science, what happened? Here we are directly giving to the input and output. You can observe in this chart, we have the input 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and also we have the labels, whatever labels we are having, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So that pattern is done by computer only. So here the machine is creating a pattern itself by taking the data from the input and the label. Both are the inputs here, label and input, both are the labels. Suppose I have given a 1 is the X value, Y is the those values. So when I am submitting these values to our data science model, automatically our model create a pattern. See here, we have the Y equals to 2X. So we can predict any value. When we have given input to both input to the machine, the machine will create a pattern and develop a pattern. Suppose if you want to predict a value at the 10, you will get the y equals to 20. In the traditional machine learning problem, that job is very difficult for them. And as well as nowadays, all traditional programs replaced by the data science. So next to 20 years, data science will lead the role. Maximum, this is a sad news for us, maximum software people will lose their jobs due to this data science and artificial intelligence. And how that developed here, data science. So first, we have the data mining. So in the data mining, whatever data we are having, in the data we are taking the insights. What are the insights in the data? If you want to know something, that time we have used a statistical methods. Suppose if I take the data, I will take the average value of the student's marks. You will get the average is the 60, that is the central value. Based on that, we know that that entire class performance. It's the average performance or below average or above average the performance. So whenever we have the data, in that data, if we want to finding any insights, we are using the statistical methods and tools. And not only statistical methods and tools, we are using the visualization also. Visualization also creating some insights from the data. Next, after that, what we have? We have the machine learning. So when the word is coming to machine learning, people may getting shocked. So this is a tough word. So we don't touch that word. So we don't learn that word also. The machine learning is nothing but a statistical approach. So we have the different kinds of the key statistical models. We are using those key statistical models to predicting the future. So that is the main objective of this machine learning. The machine learning is going to change the entire world in future. So present already, the machine learning given excellent solutions for different domains. Next, if you want to become a data scientist, what are the prerequisites are required for you? That is also very important. And if you want to do any analytics or any deep learning or machine learning or natural language, so don't confuse, these are all the terminologies. So one by one, you have to focus on these terminologies. Definitely you will get the idea about these are all the terminologies also. I'm not using the complex terminologies here. So in this data science, if you want to learn the data science, first we need to go for the computer science. So you should have the computer science basic knowledge. Next, mathematics knowledge. You should require the mathematics knowledge, which is belongs to related to the statistics. So whatever statistics are, we have the statistics models and tools, how that statistical models and tools are working by using the mathematical calculations. So maximum, I am not giving the mathematics. Generally, they have mentioned the mathematics, but here mathematics are not playing a major role. Just generally, we are using the linear algebra and some other cases we are using the mathematics, but maximum portion belongs to the statistical. So in that statistical also, statistical research, already everybody knows that we have the statistical subject in our MBA also. And in that statistical subject, we have the null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, and we have the different types of measures of dispersion. And we also have the linear regression. These are all comes under the statistical research. So that knowledge we require. And domain expertise is very important. This is not learned by classrooms. This is learned by yourself only. How it is happening from the experience, we are getting the domain knowledge. So we need to understand complete problem perfectly. When we understand the problem perfectly, automatically we will find the solution. Suppose I will take the computer science student. He does not have the domain knowledge. Why? Because he is having the programming knowledge, but there is no domain knowledge. There is no use of to do data science. So data science is to solving the real world business problems. Whatever real time we are facing the problem, this data science is helping to us to solving the real world problems. So in that data processing is also comes under the computer science. So if you have the knowledge, computer science, basic computer science knowledge and strong statistical knowledge and some marketing, retail and manufacturing, different domains. Do you have the experience in that? Definitely everybody will become a data scientist. And this is the entire portion of the data science related things. And people are hearing about the artificial intelligence also. And when people are listening this word also, people are getting the fear about this word. So there is no fear about this. Everything is comes from the statistics only. Whatever we applied in our MBA and what we learned in our degree. So these are all the techniques we are applying here in a different manner. So when I want to talk about the artificial intelligence, in that artificial intelligence, if you want to develop any artificial intelligence product, we need to apply the machine learning and deep learning. So here you should have the clarity about that. Machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence, and artificial intelligence is also having different areas also. But maximum machine learning is a part of the artificial intelligence. Any scientific techniques, robotics techniques we are applying, that time also we are using the artificial intelligence. And if you want to do any robotics related things also, we are applying machine learning. So I don't want to go in depth on that, and just I will give clarity about that. Machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence. The diagram is showing like that. The machine learning is a part of artificial intelligence, and deep learning is a part of machine learning. So you may understand this. Machine learning is a part of the artificial intelligence, and deep learning is a part of the machine learning. We will discuss about machine learning and deep learning also later. And if you want to do any kind of operation or any kind of statistical model, any kind of key algorithms do you want to apply, that time we need to know these are all the libraries. Here language is one of the technique that will solve our business problems, and language is not a criteria. So any language you can use. Here I am using the Python. You can use R, you can use Java or any other language. Traditionally, we are using the Python. Nowadays, Python is occupying almost 95% to solving the real world business problems as well as data science problems also. In this, we have the libraries like that. You may confuse what is the library and everything, but these are all the packages. Packages means already they have developed some key algorithms. They have already developed, not to require a develop to the algorithm, just you have to use that algorithm and solve your problem. That's it. Very simple. How we are solving the problem by using the Excel sheet. So like that only we are doing some coding and we are solving the real world business problems. So if you want to find the standard deviation in Excel sheet, how we are entering the values, like that standard deviation formula background is different. Whatever Excel sheet you are seeing, that is the user interface. A background, that entire code is different. So you can't see that code. So here also same thing. These are all the libraries are helping to us. They have already developed different types of key statistical algorithms. Just we are taking those key statistical algorithms and we are applying. So for if you want to becoming a data scientist or you want to becoming a data science faculty, you should know these are all the libraries: Keras, Matplotlib library, GenSim, NumPy, Sklearn, TensorFlow. These are all the major libraries to solving real world business problems. And here a very important concept is the types of machine learning. What are the types of the machine learning? So when we are solving the problem, we have the different types of data. So the data is the types here. We are having the different types of the data. Based on the data types only, we are applying the algorithms. So here we have the different types of the data: supervised data, unsupervised data, and reinforcement data. So when we will talk about the supervised data, the supervised data is labeled data. Unsupervised data is unlabeled data. Reinforcement data is by mistakes we will learn and we will do, like whatever gaming is going on your mobiles, that is reinforcement learning. And here supervised learning, we have the labels, whatever example have shown before you, whatever input I have given X, and also I have given a label is Y, and I have given label and X value, and finally I got that pattern. So people may confuse what is the supervised data. The supervised data is like this. Suppose we have the grapes. So what we have an image, or we have the image. So when we are seeing the image, we know that is the grapes. The grape is the label for that. The image, we are having the image. So in that image, we need a label. Means without label, we don't know. So when we are showing this product to our kids, how they will learn, we will see, they will see maximum 100 times or 200 times, that time they may learn. So every time we are saying to them, it is a grape to our child. So automatically he learned from that. So same thing is happening in the data science also. Just whatever data we are having, just we have to give the label. And after given three labels, means first you have given one image and also given a label, this is the grape. And second image you have given a grape and you also given a label is grape. And third image you have given and third image also label. So and fourth image we have not given a label. So automatically the machine learning is gives you output, it is a grape. So unknown object also it will identify. So that's why whenever you want to develop any kind of the machine learning or deep learning natural language processing, we are using the we need a data. How much data we are having, that much our accuracy will come out. So not only this, I will give machine learning related also. Suppose the person is having the diabetic or not. When that person is having diabetic or not, we have the columns like that, BP levels and sugar levels and pregnancy. So these are all the columns. Our target variable is that person is having diabetic or not. The person is having the diabetic is yes. The person is not having the diabetes, no. So that kind of data you can think, you can imagine it is an Excel sheet. In that Excel sheet, we have the three columns and fourth column is diabetic. Suppose another person came to my clinic and just I will enter the three input, definitely I will get the output. That person is having the diabetic or not without any kind of the blood test like that. So when I enter the field, definitely I will find out that. And also you can think about when we are applying a loan, they are asking some features for us. So whatever features here, feature means column, means one attribute. So don't confuse that also. And here when we are entering to the features, different features we are entered, automatically we are having the loan eligibility or not, automatically we'll get it. So that is also one of the supervised technique. Means we have the previous, we have the data, we have taken a 100 customers data with the labels, we have given a training to our system, and another 50 customers, new customers came, and we will decide that we will give to loan to those persons or not. So that time we required a label data. So in this case, we are using the supervised learning. That is unsupervised learning, means it is unlabeled data. Previous, we know that the person is having the diabetes, we have the different attributes. Suppose here we don't know the person is having diabetes or not. So there is no target column here, there is no label here. So that is a different case. So we need to cluster the entire data. So automatically it will cluster. Previous, we have given a name to the that particular grape. Now I am not giving to the name to the particular product. We have the apple and orange, and we are not like to give the names to these items. Just I want to segregate this. So by using the clustering technique, that is also one of the key statistical technique we are using here, and it will automatically clustering that. But after clustering this, we will give the label for that. So here we are using the different types of the techniques. Suppose I will give the example. We have the coconut, and we have the apple, we have the coconut, and we are also having the watermelon. So I need to segregate that. So when I have, what is the logic I am having here to segregate that? So the distance is 10 centimeters. It will become a apple. 10 to 15 centimeters. It is belongs to the apple. Suppose the distance between 30 to 40, it is belongs to coconut, and it is the distance between means the radius of that particular item. Means we can pass that item into the one of the measurable item. You can put one of the measurable item. The measurable item will segregate. Those are all the products. So clusters means it is sending to the when we are passing the apple, that size is very less, it is sending to the left side. person when you are passing the another product. These are all the reality of the data science. These are all the real-time products we are making. So when the size is more that, and it will go to the right side and left side. So here logic is that what is the width of that particular product. Based on the width, we are clustering the objects. So these are all the unsupervised data. So unsupervised data is helpful to us to solving any kind of business problem. Suppose you want to target a particular customer. Those person's income is very high. I will target those customers and I will give credit card to them. So how we will know that? We have the income levels of all the persons and their age and everything. And based on that, I will cluster that. So these people are having the income is high, and these people are having the moderate, and these people are the low. So just I'm clustering, not there is no label here. So for this, I will target my customers and I will sell my product to them. So this is the unsupervised learning. What is the previous I told that supervised learning is having the label. Means here Apple is there, Apple label will be there in that. But here there is no label for the Apple, but we can segregate that. After segregating the all these, then we will give the label for that. And reinforcement learning, this is the deep concept, but I don't want to talk more about this. In this, reinforcement learning is learning from the mistakes. So when we are beating to our kids or any other, when they are doing the mistakes, we are telling to them, so don't do like that. This robot's also working like that. So when they are doing the mistakes, we are giving training to them. Again, it will not do that kind of the mistake. So gaming, maximum in the gaming side, we are using the reinforcement learning. So maximum data scientists are not working related to this reinforcement learning. Rare cases we are working with this, and this is a different concept. And maximum cases we are working with the supervised unsupervised data. And previously I'm talking about always statistical algorithms and statistical algorithms. So today topic also there, what are the statistical tools and applications, and what are the applications of the data science. So these are all the statistical algorithms I want to tell you. Here already we have discussed the types of the machine learning. In this we have the supervised, unsupervised reinforcement. So here what are the algorithms are there in the supervised. In the supervised, we are using the statistical algorithm called regression. And regression also having total 12 kinds of the regressions we have, but here I have given a linear and polynomial. And logistic regression also most important in this case, not this one. And regression, we have the linear and polynomial. And in the regression problem, we can use decision trees also. And random forest is the ensemble technique, means we will take the more trees and solving the real world problem. So if you take the decision tree, single decision tree, the model may fit, overfitted problem will be there in this. So that's why to avoiding this kind of the problem, we are using the random forest. That is also regression model. And in the regression, and we are having the classification also in the supervised data, another kind of problems also there, that those are all classification problems. And to solving this classification problems, we are using the k nearest neighbor. And again, we are using the decision tree, random forest. Here you can remember that decision tree and random forest, we can solve the problems is regression and classification. And here logistic regression for classification, means that is also linear problem. So that is called logistic regression. So in the linear models are here linear regression and logistic regression, but logistic regression is helping to us to solving the binary classification problem. What previous I have discussed about that, the person is having diabetic or not, that is the binary classification model, yes, no. So if you want to solve those kind of problems, we are using the regression techniques. And also we are using the SVM, support vector machines also, for classifying the data. Means here that is also classification. So here you need to understand here regression and classification. These both the concepts are very important. Regression is the useful for the continuous variable. Means suppose if you want to find the house price, it depends on different features. So that target variable is continuous. It is a 5 lakhs or 6 lakhs or 20 lakhs or 25 lakhs. The target variable is continuous. So in that case only we are using the regression techniques. So in the decision tree also regression, we can solve the regression problem. And in the classification, the person is having that diabetic or not, yes or no. That time we can use the logistic regression. Suppose if I want to solve the problem like crop is having the four kinds of the diseases, in that case I will classify the I will use the classification problem. This is one type, this is two, this is three, this is four. So once I have given a features of a particular leaf, automatically which disease that leaf is having, you will get the output. So that may confusing to you, but this is the problem we can solve. So in the classification, we have the logistic regression, SVM, decision trees. Again, decision trees we are using, and random forest also we can use in this classification. The advantages from the decision tree and random forest is there. We can use decision tree and random forest in both regression kind of problem and classification kind of problem. So that is the major advantage. And nowadays we are using random forest. Random forest is occupying almost 90%. Advanced for this, we are having the XGBoost. I don't want to discuss that. XGBoost is the ultimate solutions we are getting here. And next, already have discussed about the unsupervised data. There is no label, means there is no target variable. So only we have the features. We need to segregate those features and classify those features by using the clustering concepts. So here we are having the different kinds of the clustering concepts, K-means clustering and PCA and SVD. I don't want to go depth with that. So these are all the clustering concepts we can use. And another unsupervised technique is there. Associate analysis means a priori algorithms. So when you are running a retail shop, and what product after what product we have to put, we have to arrange in our retail shop. Suppose milk and bread, both are beside. So automatically your sales will increase. So how we will know that which product and which product is having the association? So based on this association analysis, we know that how to arranging our retail store, our products by using this association analysis. And also we can call market basket analysis also. Sorry. And reinforcement learning, that is a totally different concept. I don't want to go for that. And here in the clustering PC and K means we can use the continuous variable, and categorical, we can use the categorical association rule. So one more is there below. Yeah, Markov model analysis, that is we can like a game theory, what is the competitor is doing and what are the strategies we need to apply, how much probabilities we are getting. So depending on the probability related that. I don't want to go through all the algorithms, just I'm giving the brief about what is the data science. Today class is very important for everyone. If you want to learn this, you need to spend almost 1 year. In the 1 year span of time, I am just summarizing and I'm giving brief about that, what is the data science, how to learn and how to do that, and how to we can apply the applications. So for this is the process of data science. So this is the generic process and generalized process. In this first step, we have to get the data, and we need to explore the data, and we need to build a model, and we need to analyze result and simulate the result and use the results in your business. Very simple. We have to get the data from different sources. It's a big data or any other data is there. You can get the data and you have to explore that. Exploring means here you have to do some analysis, statistical analysis. What is the mean, median, mode, and how to handling the missing values, and what is the logic of that to handling the missing values. And we need to visualize the data and we will find the patterns. Suppose if I visualize the data, is 70 people or not, is 30 people are willing to take a premier subscription for the any other mobile songs related app. So 30 is the 30 people are taking, that means is 30 we are getting the almost 90% people are willing to take subscription of that. So that time we can understand, when visualizing the data we can understand whenever we are having.
Sorry, your voice is breaking, sir, in between.
Okay, I'm very sorry. Continuously.
Hello, sir.
Continuously breaking. Hello.
Yeah, we can hear now, sir. We can hear.
My voice is continuously breaking or not?
Now it is clear, sir.
Yeah, it's breaking on and off. It is missing, sir, actually.
Okay, maybe disturbance is there or not. Everybody is following me or not? Please confirm. Hello.
Yes, sir. We are following, sir. It's nice, sir.
Thank you. So here we need to get the data and explore the data, means some visualization and some statistical mean, median, mode, any other statistical things are required, any null hypothesis technique is required, we can apply here and we can find some insights in the data. After that, we will decide that which model we have to apply, what kind of the model is suitable for this data. It is a labeled data, it is a classification, we can go over the classification algorithms. The data is unlabeled data, we will go for the clustering concept like that. And after that, whatever results we are getting, we need to visualize those results, and we have to evaluate those results. By simulating those results, we will know that any improvement is required, we'll go for the improvements. And finally, we can use that use case for our business purpose. So whatever training model we have built, we can take that training model and we will do the predictions. So whatever example starting I have mentioned, 2x here, when we got the model means we got the 2x. When you are entering the x value, automatically you'll get the y value. So we will get the predictions like that. But in the global scenario, that will not work. 2x or 2y that will not work. I will show you what is going on now. And this is the data science workflow. Already whatever previous we have discussed, those are all the steps. And whatever data set we are getting, next we need to clean the data, we need to handling the missing values. And the next step, we need to go for the feature engineering. What are the features are important for us? Avoid the remaining features, which features are impacting to our target variable, we have to select those features only. And after that, you have to give the training to your data. And you have to split the data into training and test. So when we are splitting the data into training and test, we can take those test data, how our model is performing. So general, we will take 80-20 or 70-30, 70 data points for the training and 30 data points, 30 data points means 30% data points for the testing. This is the new data, 30 data points for the testing. So when we are using the testing, that outcome, what is the label is coming, it is coming true positive or false positive or any other. So we will do some analysis on that. So here training data, whatever training we have taken, the 70% we are passing to through our model. Automatically it is learning, our algorithm will learn. We will build a one training model, means like whatever 2x I have mentioned, like that we'll get one pattern here, means one weights, we get some weights here. So whatever we got that weights, we will give the new values to them. Means whatever test or new data is there. New data means we will get the predictions. Here, this is the new data, that is the test data. How keep 30% for the testing. Whatever testing data I'm having here, I'm passing through my model and I will get the score. Score means our accuracy, how much accuracy we got it. For the classification, we are using the accuracy concept is the confusion matrix. And regression, we are using the mean sum of squares and root mean sum of squares. So different kinds of techniques are there. I don't want to go through that. Just generally you can understand what is happening in the data science field. So here in this score, after that we will evaluate. Our model is got 70% accuracy. Again, we will retrain our model. Again, we will get the 80%. And between this in the training model, we are having the some hyperparametric tuning techniques. So we will make some changes of the hyperparameters. So based on that, we will improve our model. And different kinds of the hyperparametric techniques also there, grid search CV, random search CV. So I don't want to go in depth. So when you are getting the less accuracy, again, we will go and do hyperparameter tuning. We can increase our model performance. And this is the way we are doing the problem. We have the labeled data, triangle, square, and trapezium. And in this, we will pause our model. And we have having the testing data also. And once we have predicted that, we will get the same prediction. Our model is 100% accuracy. So whatever test we have given, we got the same values. Our model is 100% accuracy. If it is not predicted like that, this is the test data I have given. So our model is not perfect. So we will need some hyperparameter tuning and we require to rebuild our model. So this is the basic architecture of the data science problems. So whatever previous I have discussed, if you want to find out that the person is having diabetes or not. So already I have given, observe in this data, we have the pregnancies, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI, and age, different features we are having. The features means this one, this is the data. You will get the data like this. You will get the data like this CSV file or Oracle or any other file, Excel or anything. So your target outcome is your target 1010. 1 means he is having diabetes, that person is diabetic, and 0 is that person is not diabetic. So I will take this data, I will pass this entire data into my model. So when I have given a training, the model take this entire data and I will build a one model. Suppose I have another hospital data. In that hospital data, there is no outcome. Sir, you need to identify these persons, which are the persons will have the diabetic or not. So I don't use any blood test. Whatever glucose levels and blood pressure and whatever data they have given that data, I will predict that data and I will give output to them. So this person is having diabetic and this person is not having diabetic. And that is also whatever labeled data we are having. In that labeled data, whatever split we have splitted, that is the 80 or 20 or 70 or 30, our accuracy is more than 97%. Definitely our model will perform unknown data also. So this is the way we are solving the problems. So not go for the diabetic. Diabetic is a basic example. In the real time, it will not be there. We will have the huge case. We will use the big data. So in the big data, we will give the loan to a particular person or not, based on the different features. And everybody knows that we are having the COVID app. Narendra Modi developed that. So when we are entered all the features, automatically it is giving to that. Whatever depends on your symptoms, you will have a COVID. So you will go and take the test for that. Otherwise, based on those symptoms, you will not have that. So not only this, if you give me the X-ray to me and I will pass your X-ray to my model is automatically predict the person is having COVID or not. So I will show how that is also happening. Whatever discussion I'm doing, this is totally belongs to machine learning. Means machine learning, maximum we are having the CSV file like that. And don't forget, deep learning is a part of machine learning. I will go and discuss about the deep learning. And don't forget that deep learning is a part of machine learning. Maximum in the machine learning problems, we are having the Excel sheet or CSV file or Oracle file like that. So here also we will classify the persons. Means classify means we will which persons are having diabetic and which persons are having no diabetic. We will find by using the different features. And everybody is seeing this. Now I'm talking about the applications. And first one is the application in the medical side. And in the recommendation system, every day we are seeing the Amazon and Flipkart. And the Amazon and Flipkart, when we are seeing, you don't know what is happening, background, what is happening. Background, we are applying machine learning technique. That is also a recommendation system. And we know that correlation, background, it is running correlation. People doesn't know what is going on background. So here we are using the correlation and we are using the cosine similarity kind of algorithms we are using background. So if you see one product laptop, again, it is recommending the laptop only. Suppose yesterday you have seen some product and some same product is appearing right side or left side. Means it is taking the correlation, the person's correlation. And suppose your friend is seeing always comedy movies and your friend also getting same notification. You also getting same notification. You don't know why we both are getting. Means his interest also comedy movie, your interest also comedy movie. Every time you are searching comedy movie, automatically system will generate you comedy movie only. So it will recommend, the system is recommending to you comedy movie only. So if you are seeing horror movie, the system is recommending horror movie. So everybody is understanding what is the recommendation system, what is the background is happening. In the background, we are having the cosine similarity and correlation. Nothing is not happening in this. And weather forecasting. So weather forecasting also machine learning technique. We are in our mobiles every day. We are seeing weather. And what is the next moment? What will happen in the next moment or next second or next minute? So we have the data, previous day's data. Based on the previous day data, we will predict that tomorrow what will happen. This is also one of the classification and time series combined technique. And now I would like to talk about the deep learning. Previous whatever applications we have discussed, those are all belongs to machine learning related. Now we will discussing about the deep learning. The deep learning is totally belongs to image data. Previous we have discussed about the features and features data and label data. Here totally belongs to the image data. We will take the images and we will do our analysis. Whatever previous case I told you, if you have given me X-ray, definitely I will find out that the person is having the COVID or not. So in the medical, the doctor will not identify the person is having the COVID or not, but model is giving 97% accuracy to the patients. That's why every doctor is following this data science technique. So what is the background is happening, same like that, whatever previous you have seen, the numbers game, everything is belongs to numbers games in the data science field. Whatever image we are seeing, left side is a black and white. When we are having the white, that time you get the one. And when we are having the black, we are getting the zeros. So entire data is converting into the zeros and ones. So here you can observe, left side, we are having the rows and column. Everybody is following, please. Hello.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just I don't have another system. That's why I'm confusing myself.
Yeah, we can see.
Yeah, please respond.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. So whatever numbers we are having in the columns row, whatever previous data you have seen in the diabetic, you can think like that. We have the columns. Columns means features. In the rows means data points. So in this image also, I converted into the rows and columns. Now my task is very simple. So I can pass this entire values into machine learning, or otherwise I will go and use the deep learning techniques. The deep learning techniques are little bit different than the machine learning techniques. So now everybody is understanding these columns and rows, how image is converting. This is the black and white image is converting zeros ones. If I take the color image, that will converting into 0 to 255. The pixel values will be the 0 to 255. So this is the architecture of the deep learning. Don't take too much of this. And I will give some basic introduction about this. Whatever features we are having, F1, F2, F3 means column 1, column 2, column 3, we will pass this column 1, column 2, column 3 to these neurons. So in that neurons, we are having the activation functions. I don't want to go depth in that also. This is a big concept for that. So when we are passing, these are all the features. Here I have given a Bhadra. This is the Bhadra image, my label. So whatever image I have given here, Bhadra image I have given to my model. And here I have put in my label is Bhadra. So this entire image comes to the target. The target variable is Bhadra. It's a name I have given. Bhadra means name I have given. I can convert name into one. So one means Bhadra, zero means no Bhadra. So here it will take one. And after seeing this, it is not matching actual whatever training data I have given. Actually, I have given a one, but it is not matching. I got the value 0.001. So the model is understanding. So here Bhadra is there. My model is predicting no Bhadra. So I need more train, and it will go for the back propagation. So it is changing the weights and it is learning something from this part. So background, we are using the gradient descent. Based on the gradient descent, this back propagation is happening. And finally, it will learn the Bhadra. I've given one image Bhadra and second image Bhadra and third image Bhadra. And fifth image, I have given a Bhadra image. And fifth image, it will identify is a Bhadra. So whatever persons, we have the 2 lakhs or 5 lakhs or 20 lakhs or 1 crore or 100 crores or 700 crores or 800 crores people are there in the world, it will predict perfectly. So we are seeing the Facebook. Facebook is the best example in the deep learning. So it will automatically tagging in your photo, Bhadra is there, can I tag you or not? So like that, every face is different from others. Yeah, nowadays we are using the face recognition instead of using the biometric. So that is also one of the deep learning application. And like that, I will give the previous, I have given only Bhadra image. I will send 100 images like cat, tiger, or dog, and I will run my model in the deep learning model. Not only deep learning model, you can convert deep learning model into the rows and columns, you will give to machine learning. Automatically, we will know that. In the place of diabetic 1-0, in the place of target variable, we'll give the Bhadra. One means yes, no Bhadra. So like that, after converting the numerical values. So nowadays in the medical side, every area, any operation is doing nowadays, they are using the deep learning technique. So if you give me the X-ray, I have the four classes here. In that four classes, we have the normal bacterial pneumonia, COVID pneumonia, and viral pneumonia. Whenever you have given an image to me, I definitely will classify by using the deep learning technique. In the deep learning technique, code is also just 50 to 60 lines. After developing this code, I will make a one website. In that website, you are applied your image, definitely you will get it that. Nowadays, all the doctors are using this. So every doctor is using deep learning technique. They are not observing the, if the radiology also observing the image, he may not identify that person is having COVID or not. When we are giving image to our model, definitely our model will identify that person is having COVID or not. Here we got the 99.9% accuracy. This project I have developed in my organization. And my favorite my motivation person, Elon Musk, I'm always thinking about this person. That motivation only turned into the data science. And he taught 5 years back, I will come up with a driverless car. That time everybody is laughing. So whatever driverless car technique is there, this is also one of the application of deep learning. Whatever driverless car is there, everything is belongs to deep learning and data science. So everything. So how we are giving through the training to the car is that when we are having the stop signal, we can take a stop signals and we will give the training to our model. Whenever stop signal is getting, the model is identifying it is a stop signal. Whenever we are having the road, it is identified road. We will give the road images. Whenever having the person, it is identified person. So we have to give all the images to train our model. I have given almost 50 lakhs images to my model. Model may identify this is the road, this is the signal, and this is left side. We are having the some dividers also there. It is identifying its own. So based on that, car is moving when they have, and it is pressing to the brake or not. So as a human being, what we are doing when we are seeing a signal, it belongs to you. You can cross the signal or you can go. But whenever we have applied this driverless car technique, the car will not do like that. Whatever human mistakes we are doing here, and car will not do that mistakes. And 99.9% this car is very safe and it is avoiding the accidents. And already previous I have discussed what is the use of deep learning in the Facebook also. Every person, when we are uploading your image, automatically in the background it is converting to the numerical values and it is storing a Bhadra name. Whenever that person is come in your photograph, automatically it is asking Bhadra, is there, can I tag him or not? So entire Facebook activity, entire Amazon activity belongs to this only, belongs to data science. And if you want to predicting the stock also, we are using the deep learning. So if you want to predict the stock value, what will happen next? And we have the time series technique also. We are having the ARIMA models like that. So in the deep learning, we have the LSTM. LSTM will give the better accuracy for us. And next, we can see more applications we are having deep learning, self-driving car, and automatic handwriting generation. Whatever you have written, it will convert into the text. These are all apps you are seeing. These are all the apps developed by data scientists only. And here, pixel restoration means whatever black and white image, old image are there, it will present neatly. And colorization of the background, any old movie can colorizing the images and doing that, and deep dreaming. And whenever we are in the black, if you take an image in a dark, and that automatically give the brightness, and detection of growth delays in children's. So how the children is growing, and we can take the 20,000 to 30,000 images of the growing of the children's, and we will do analysis on that. And what are the precautions we need to take when children is growing, and demographic predictions. Already you know that some people are using, maximum ladies are using this app. What is the age of the person? When you have given your photo to the app, automatically app is saying that your weight is this, and your height is this, and your age is this. So this is also, we have taken a 20 to 30,000 people height, weight, and their age. Based on that, we have given a training. The model is predicting. When you are giving to the app, automatically app is predicting like that. And previous, I talk about CSV files and images. And here, sound also we are converting into the numerical values. Music also. Not required in future, not required music directors. We can make in our own music by using the deep learning techniques. And news aggregations. Suppose I am not interested to see all the news. Somebody should segregate those news. I will go for only sports news. So I will give newspaper to my model. Means I will give that image to my mobile. Mobile automatically capture that sports news and it is displaying to you. So it is a news aggregation. Here we are using the clustering concept. And automatic machine translation. Nowadays, we are using the translation of English to Urdu, Urdu to Telugu, Telugu to English. So this all background task is done by a data scientist only. And this is the natural language processing. And previous, what I told that translation also natural language processing, but it is a deep learning technique. Previous, that is deep learning technique. That's why I've given application is deep learning. And here in the natural language processing means, previous we taught about CSV file and image. Now I'm talking about the text. So how the text is converting to the numerical values, that is very important here. Every time this is a new number game, we have to convert all this into numerical values. We will play with the numbers. So like that, you can see I enjoy flying. I like NLP. I like deep learning. I converted that into the numerical values. I will give that entire sentence to my model. It is a positive sentence or negative sentence. Suppose we are getting the reviews. I will give the training to take the every review. My target variable is a positive review and negative review. I will train my model whatever comment they commented, and based on that I will know that some other person is commented like the commented. I know that that comment is the positive comment towards my product or not. So that time you are using this word to vec, means whatever words we are having converting to the vectors. We are giving the machine learning, or you can give the training to the training by deep learning, whatever concept you are wishing to that. So you can apply machine learning or deep learning, definitely will get the model output. So little bit confusing to you, but you can think about this. Previous, we have talked about the numerical values. Second, we taught about images. Now we are discussing about the text data. So how we can playing with the text. And this is very simple. Whatever every day we are seeing, but we don't know background, we have the data scientists. So AI and chatbots are developed by data scientists only. Whatever chatbot you are seeing, it is insurance, mutual fund, banking, or any chatbot you are using. And this affect almost 1 lakh people lost their jobs in customer case. So it may be going to almost 10 to 15 lakhs also within 1 year. So this is the impact of the artificial intelligence and data science. And think about that, background is statistics, not anything. And whatever Google search, initial days we are using this Google search, that time only they required hardly 10 to 15 machine learning engineers. Nowadays all the tasks they require the machine learning engineers. In our country they required 1 lakh machine learning and 1 lakh machine learning and data scientist, and availability is only 20,000. And we are seeing the Google assistancy. Okay, Google, whatever assistancy we are getting from the Google, that is also belongs to data science only. And next, Alexa, whatever Alexa we are using, that is also one of the application of the data science. And whatever words we are speaking, it is converting into the text data, and after that text we are converting into the numerical values. Based on the numerical values, what is the target, means what is the answer we have to give, whatever question we will take based on that. And we have the bet concept nowadays. Whenever some other person is typed a message, automatically it is showing that this is the reply. This is the reply for that, like that. So just give me 1 minute. I have a call actually. Sir, just give me 1 minute, please. Okay, whatever Alexa we are using, that is also belongs to this. And these are all the natural language applications. Translation application means language to language translation and fake news detection. Any fake news is there. Cybercrime department is using this fake news detection and classification emails. Suppose when you are when the persons are sending to mails to you, it will goes to the inbox and other mails will go to the spam. Means it is a classification technique background. The Google is using this classification techniques and predicting diseases. Whatever diseases are there depends on the text also. We will find the diseases and error detection also. Whatever outliers are there, we can find out those error detection. And next, IVR applications means nowadays we are having the Google assistance. That is totally IVR applications, and we can go for the sentiment analysis. In the sentiment, whatever previous I taught about that positive sentiment or negative sentiment, whatever comment is there is a positive comment or negative comment. Means whatever you want to find this, we need a data. That means the data should have labels. And finally, we have the different, I will summarize and what is the main important applications of the data science. In the e-commerce, we are identifying the consumers and recommending the products, analyzing the reviews. In the e-commerce sector, we are using this, and manufacturing, predicting potential problems, monitoring the system, and automatic manufacturing units, maintenance scheduling, anomaly detection in the manufacturing also. Means suppose in the car is damaged and how we can identify that damage. In the production process, we can't identify that, but our model will identify whichever car is having the damage and how much percentage the car is having damage. It is having the damage 1% or 2% also, it will identify and it will show that which portion of the part is having defect in that. In the banking sector also, maximum in the banking sector, they are using data science, fraud detection and credit risk modeling, consumer lifetime value, means churn or not, means the customer is with the bank or not. In the healthcare sector also, we are using this. In the healthcare image analysis, previous I told about that X-rays and drug discovery. Now whatever COVID drug is discovered, that also discovered by data science concept only. Bioinformatics and virtual assistants. And next in this transport also, self-driving car, enhanced driving experiences, car monitoring systems, enhancing safety of progress passengers. In the transportation domain also we are using this. In the finance domain also we are using customer segmentation and strategic decision making, automatic trading and risk analytics. So credit risk analytics also we can do. So all the areas we are using data science. That's all about all the data science. So I will give 5 questions, then after I will answer your questions. So those who are answer those questions, first come first or best, you will get surprise gift. I will take the address from the organizers. I will send a gift to them. So I need perfect answers. Whatever discussion we have done so far, based on that only you will get the questions. So where is my chat bot? Everybody is ready for this?
Yes, we are ready, sir.
I think everybody got the questions. Yeah, first come first serve. Now only we will announce winner. Time is timeline is only 5 minutes. 11:12, 11:17 is time period. Single text only we need to give answer. Single chart text. All the questions at a time. Pushpalata madam has given. Jairam sir has given logical answer, 3 types. Anaya. Yes, Anaya. Anaya dot. Anaya dot. Reach the goal. Who is the Anaya dot? Come to the frame, please.
It is much more personal.
Okay, thank you all actively participated in this, and Tanya Das got the prize for this contest. Tanya Das, can you please come on the frame? Please put on your video if it's possible, otherwise you can put a message. Not. Okay, madam is saying that video is not required. Congratulations, madam. Tanya Das, madam, and Pushpalata madam also given similar answers. And Sar Rima Saxena. Rima Saxena also given, and starting Jairam sir also given a few answers, but finally Tanya madam has given a better answer. Tanya Das. Yeah, thank you for participating this. Do you have any doubts, ask me.
Siddhartha,
please. Siddhartha, please. of your voice. Yeah, if anybody is having doubt, please ask.
Sir, natural language processing is under deep learning, or it is different?
No, natural language is also part of the deep learning, but we can't say it's a deep learning part. Maximum in the deep learning, we will discuss about the images. In the natural language is the separate concept. In that natural language processing, we are using the text data. Maximum in the artificial intelligence, we are using the natural language processing. Whatever our general models, machine learning and deep learning we are using, that is also part of artificial intelligence. And this natural language is also a separate concept, but to solving this NLP problems, we are using ML algorithms, whatever we have discussed, decision tree, and some other advanced algorithm also there in that XGBoost kind of algorithms. Hardly we will have 15 to 16 algorithms, entire concepts in data science.
Okay.
Sir, I have 11:30. I have the meeting. Please, anybody want to ask the questions, you can ask me.
Yeah, hello, sir. This is Pushpalata.
Yeah.
I just have a doubt. Whenever we go with classification problem and clustering problem, clustering is used for unsupervised and classification is used for supervised, no?
Yeah.
So I just always have a confusion that when we have to go with clustering and when we go with classification. Now I think I am clear now, but still more examples on clustering.
Yeah, clustering is if you want to segmenting the data, that time you are using the clustering concept. Means you have the...
You told market basket. You have given market basket analysis can be an example of clustering.
Yeah. Not a market basket is not an example of clustering. It is an unsupervised technique. That algorithm is different, okay. And clustering algorithm is different. Clustering algorithm is for segmenting the people, means based on the income or age or whatever it may be, we will segmenting the people, clustering the people. In the market basket analysis, whatever data we are having, we are finding the relationship between the product to product. Bread and milk, both are having the high correlation. So I will recommend the milk, I will give the bread to recommend to them. So bread and milk you have arranged in a retail shop, automatically your sales will increase. So how we can arranging in our items in a retail shop? If you want to decide that, in that process, we are using the market basket analysis.
Yeah, got it. Whenever we go with Amazon or Flipkart, that is market basket analysis where they are recommending us that, are the products we have bought. No.
That is also a different case. In the Amazon, Flipkart, that recommendation system is different and retail store recommendation system is different. In the Amazon, Flipkart, we are using the correlation and cosine similarity. And in the retail store, we are using this market basket analysis. So whatever data we are having, everyday customers are buying, based on that, we will arrange our products.
Okay. That is recommendation. Whatever frequently, whatever we are buying, that is based on recommendation. And
In the recommendation, we are using the correlation and cosine similarity. Suppose you can take the example of Flipkart and Amazon. Background algorithm is correlation and cosine similarity. They are not using the market basket analysis.
Okay. Got it, sir. Now clear.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, welcome, ma'am.
Sir, I have a question. This data science will be replacing the jobs of software people, drivers, as well as other people. So what? So then this will be doing all the work, people will do, they will learn data science at that time to save.
Yeah. Nowadays, all the software people are looking to take courses in data science. But here, drawback is that those people doesn't have the statistical knowledge. They may not understand also what is the business problem and all. Only business plus statistics plus basic knowledge in programming, definitely those people will do this kind of work. So the software people are, the software people also looking forward towards data scientists.
Okay.
So everything is automation nowadays. Just we are giving, his name is Badra, photo I have given, automatically algorithm done by the machine only. So not required to write entire code. Automatically machine will learn. If I have given a Siddhartha sir photos 4 and Badra Rao photos 4, it will segregate Badra Rao and Siddhartha. And sixth photo I have given a Badra Rao. Yeah, Badra Rao, this person is Badra Rao. Suppose sixth photo I have given Siddhartha without label I have given. So this person is Siddhartha. That will give, the machine will give answer to us. Not required, but every time we required a training data. Means Siddhartha photos, 5 photos required here, and Badra Rao, 5 photos required here.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sir, small doubt. Whenever we go with continuous variables, we are using in clustering SVD, PCA, and K-means.
Yeah.
And whenever we go with categorical, so can you just specify some type of examples of categorical, like male, female, okay, sports persons, images, like now you told Apple and this. So any real-time business categorical cases, you can just explain, sir, for understanding association analysis only.
So whatever
example, I'm just having a small doubt.
Yeah. Whenever feature is there, age is there, it is a continuous variable. So we have the ages 10, 20, 30, up to 100. So it is a continuous variable. So that is one of the feature in there in our data. So you can go for clustering. So in our data, we have the product like products. The column is product.
Mm.
Below you have the bread, milk, like kind of that. So we have to go for the categorical.
Okay, okay. So if at all we are having variety of items, then we can go with categorical.
Anything is there in the column, we are having the, suppose city is there, city, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Hyderabad, Bangalore.
State.
It is category.
Okay.
It is category. And I want to take the house price, it is a continuous variable. So depends on the future, you have to decide which model we need to apply. Suppose we have in the if you're willing to go for the feature selection, when you are applying a model, you want to avoid all the features, which are the features are beneficial for us. If you want to select those features at the time, what you have to do, you have to select better features. If you have the categorical variables, you will go for the chi-square test. So
yes.
If it is continuous, you will go for the heat map. In visualization, we'll go for the heat map. And otherwise, we have the different kinds of random forest also helping us to selection of the features. And lasso also helping us to feature selection. So these are all different terminologies. Maybe people are confusing with this. And so I hope everybody is enjoying my lecture. So
yes, definitely we have enjoyed a lot.
I don't enter into the deep complexity in data science related. General purpose, I have given a lecture to you. And I hope everybody look at this. And definitely, I hope everybody will settle very well in.